Let's talk about table training. Once again, FlexiCapture can utilize machine learning training, which actually analyzes the invoice and finds anchor text strings and check marks, etc. And it uses that to find the data that we're missing. And it gets this input, of course, from the verification operator. So let's see how an operator can train a table. So not only can we improve recognition of standalone fields, but repeating groups such as tables as well. So we've sent two documents for recognition. Let's verify them now. And for now, I'm just going to ignore invoice date and focus on the table. And the problem that we see with the table is that the description wasn't completely recognized. So I'll scroll down a little bit and we'll have to address that. What an operator can do is delete the table in entirety. And the line items are removed here from the data form. And then we can rubber band some data. And we'll add data field by field to this newly created table. So I can select order date and select this data right here. And do the same for description. And unit price as well. And I'll add another line. I will select the next description. Let me change the size of that, as well as unit price. And I'll add another line. Oh, looks like I can make an adjustment here. Great. And here I can once again select the order date. And the description. And the unit price. Normally, one can specify just one line item, the first row, but because there was a missing order date, I went ahead and actually gave data for three rows. And now we can do something pretty unique. We can right-click on the last row and click Continue Line Items. This command attempts to detect the line items below the current line. When looking for line items below the current line, the program uses the markup information about the regions of the current and preceding lines, which was provided or adjusted by the user. If the results are unsatisfactory, the operator should correct the position of the first incorrectly detected line item and specify the fields of that line item, and then issue the Continue Line Items command again. But in this case, we can see the data was collected properly. Now I'll save my changes and go ahead and process the next document in the same way. And something that probably would help is increasing zoom. So there's a little bit more breathing room here. We can rearrange our image and our data form. Make an adjustment here. And I'll add a line item. And the third line. Oops, one more adjustment. There we go. And that data has been collected. And now once again, I'll right click and select continue line items. And we have our entire table now. I'm going to ignore the other errors and I am going to save my changes and close the task and send it to export. And if we look at the processing server monitor, we can see the documents are exported, but we also have this training stage. And because we have more than one core, we see multiple training stages. Because of those training steps, if we look in the project setup station, we can see that there now exists a field extraction training batch. And in that batch are the images that we trained. If we open it up, we'll see that the data has been correctly located in the table. And something else about field extraction training batches that really is exciting to me is the fact that we can go to that field extraction training batch and we can actually export the trained Flexi layout. So oftentimes the product of machine learning can be a black box. You can't really see the logic, but here we can actually export the trained Flexi layout, see the logic and make changes if needed, and then re-import that Flexi layout. So that's a very powerful feature. So to test the results here, I'll go to Scan Station and I'll create a new batch and load some images. I had loaded these two images, now I'll load these two images and we'll go ahead and send these into FlexiCapture and we can go to the processing server monitor and see what's going on. Pages are being recognized. Now that processing is complete, we can go to the verification station. We'll get our task and we're going to ignore errors here. We'll go ahead and take a look at the table collection, and now the entire table that we wanted, the fields that we wanted are being collected. So we were not targeting the VAT column and we're good to go with that document. And let's see the results here. Same story. We're getting good results. Now we can modify the database check rule if we have a data set containing the line item data to do an automatic verification of this data.